Hello and welcome to week one, lesson two of the Store Manager Academy. I am Stephen Farrell and I will be taking you through this lesson. Very excited to have each one of you here. This lesson is going to be mainly focused on those who have actually managed one store already. Maybe it was a low volume store and you're moving on to your second opportunity. I don't mean managing two stores at once. That's multi-level management, which we cover in our District Manager Academy and just a little bit in the Store Manager Academy. I'm talking about those managers here that have already proven themselves with their first store. Now, if you're an assistant manager going through this academy, you're going to want to take a lot of notes because when you get to the point of taking over a new store, you will already be one leg up ahead of your competition and you're going to be wildly successful. So lots of solid principles through here, through this lesson two. A couple things will be repeated from lesson one. So make sure if you have not watched the first lesson of store manager fundamentals, be sure to pause this and go back and watch that first. Now, for those of you that are a store manager right now and you're going on to take on a new store or a second store, it's likely because you have proven yourself to be a good manager. It probably means your direct boss and his or her supervisor, they trust your experience. So you should trust your experience as well. Now, during this lesson, we're gonna cover the importance of doing a store audit that you might be able to discover any current or potential issues. I can't emphasize this audit enough, and we're going to go into details. Then we will review what you will need to do during the first 30 days to set your expectations with your team and build trust with them. We'll also discuss the importance of being on the same page with your boss and how you can get the resources you're going to need during this process. I also want to discuss some general best practices of building rapport with your team. How does that sound? Are you guys ready? Okay, let's go. Let's start with a store audit, conducting a detailed store audit. Now, one of the most important things you can do before anything else is start by visiting your store prior to taking it over. You need to audit your staff, customer service standards, store cleanliness, merchandising standards, overall the in-store experience. Take detailed notes immediately after this visit and really be sure to write everything down, names, experiences, everything you witness, because you'll be able to connect the dots when you're meeting with your associates one-on-one and you'll have a better, you'll have a better strategy of how you're going to overcome some of your store's weaknesses. All right. Now, next, you're going to want to audit the financials of the store. What state is your store in right now financially? You need to figure that out. Is it profitable? Is it borderline profitable? Is it borderline losing money? Or is it hemorrhaging money? You've got to figure that out. Pull out all of the financials that you can find on the store for the last couple of years. Start picking up the trends. Now, if you don't understand how to read P&L statements, income statements, cash flow statements, balance sheets, I will have a lesson later on in this academy. You're going to want to go through that. You're going to learn everything you need to know to understand P&Ls and balance sheets and all that fun stuff and actually take actions off of what you learn. Now, after you understand the state of the store financially, you need to start developing a long-term strategy. What are you going to do to get the store back to snuff and to be profitable? You're given, just being experienced as a store manager, a district manager, a regional manager, give you some insights. We usually give a brand new store manager that's taking over his first or second store anywhere from 6 months to a year to make a store profitable again. So keep that in the back of your mind. If you can do it in 6 months, you are going to be a rock star. You're going to get promoted quickly. So these are the principles that I'm going to teach you through this academy to help you just get through all the hard stuff as quick as possible so you can start focusing on building a high performance team, which is going to build high profits for your store and get you and your team promoted. All right. Now, you want to go through the daily and weekly deposits, cash info, all the cash logs, anything that has to do with cash for the past 3 months, even up to 6 months, to see if there are any training issues or red flags. I want to share with you a story. It was when I took over, I believe it was my sixth store as a store manager. I ran, I think, I don't know, seven or eight stores before I got a multi-unit position. And I went in there. That store had not had a manager for 3 months. The front counter manager was running the store. And I'm doing exactly what I'm teaching you right now. I audit the financials of the store. Things were not looking good. And I observed the store as just a regular customer when I was doing my house hunting trip. And I knew I had a lot of work ahead of me. I knew there was going to be some issues. So one of the things I did when I actually got into the store and introduced myself to the staff is I jumped right into the office early morning. It was about 6 a.m. And I started auditing everything that had to do with cash, all the deposit slips, all the over and under on each tills to see who's, you know, needs some training and where there's some questionable, cash shortages that were going on. And one thing that really stood out right away was there was 30 days of missing deposit slips. At this company I worked for, they kept a deposit, a copy in what was called their cash log, their DCR. They sent a copy to the corporate office, and of course the bank got a copy. So there was 30 missing. So I called the front counter manager and I said, hey, I've got slips for the last 2 months, but the last 30 days, there's nothing here. Where are they at? Well, she's, began to explain that she mailed those off. And I said, well, you're not supposed to mail those off, right? You're supposed to mail one copy off, not both copies. You know, you didn't mail them off in the 2 months prior. She's like, oh, that's weird. I must have did it by accident. I'm like, okay, that's fine. And I retrained her, make sure you, for now on, that we keep a copy so we can, make sure everything's in line. And I dismissed her and, she went back to the front counter. So I immediately called the bank and it's a small town. The bank manager actually answered the phone. I said, hey, this is Steven. I'm the new manager down the road. We're missing a lot of deposit slips for the last 30 days. Here's the dates. I need to get copies of those. When's a good time to come by? And the bank manager, I could tell by the tone of her voice that something was wrong. She goes, she's stuttering. I'm like, oh no, this is bad. You guys haven't dropped a deposit off in over a month. You've just been coming to do change orders every now and then. I could not believe what my ears just heard. I said, excuse me, say that one more time. She's like, yeah, you guys have not dropped off a deposit in over a month. My jaw dropped to the floor. I was just shocked. So I immediately got on the horn with the director of loss prevention, and they flew in all their top people, and they did an interrogation. They found out the front counter manager was embezzling from the store, and she embezzled a lot. I'm not going to give you the exact amount, right? Because it was confidential, but it was so much that she embezzled that the CFO flew into this small little town, calls me into my own office and says, Steven, this store has been hemorrhaging money for about 5 years now. We weren't sure if we could make it profitable, but we were going to give it a chance with you because of your background with the last company you worked with, how you were able to make stores profitable in a short amount of time. Unfortunately, because of this embezzlement, Steven, it was such a large amount. It wasn't your fault. You just found it. We appreciate you finding it for us. Who did it, but unfortunately, we're going to have to close this store. I was just... Guys, my heart just dropped out of my chest, okay? I was here. I just moved my entire family from Utah all the way to the Midwest, okay? We just got up and moved for this opportunity. And here I'm being told that my store is going to close. And yeah, they're going to find me a home somewhere, maybe in Texas or something. But that's it, guys. This is my opportunity to shine. And the first thing I get, as a thank you is the CFO telling me they're going to close my store. I told him, no, you've got to give me at least 3 months to turn things around. I will make this store profitable within 6 months. I'll get everything fixed in three and we'll be profitable in six. And I went back and forth with the CFO guys for about a half an hour, and the director of loss prevention was there and a whole bunch of other important people, and everybody was on the CFO's side. But eventually, he trusted me. He gave me that chance. And I'm proud to tell you today that that store did not close. I did make it profitable within 6 months. I won the community's trust back. And that store was one of the best stores in the company. But long story short, Guys, you have to trust. You have to check. You've got to verify. What's that saying that Ronald Reagan was famous for? Trust, but verify. I could have trusted my front counter manager when she said, oh, I must have just mailed them off to the corporate office. But I verified. And guess what? She took every one of those deposits home and paid off her car and half of her house. So you want to audit everything that has to do with cash immediately when you first get into the store. Any questions? All right. After viewing the cash logs, after doing that audit, you need to now review employee files. Only active employees, okay? That's where you want to start first. And you want to figure out who are your troublemakers and who is borderline ready to be let go. Makes sense? You want to connect the dots on who's who. When you're interviewing with your associates one-on-one, you're meeting with Sally Mae, and you see she's been written up the last 5 days for attendance. You get in and talk to her, and she really doesn't like her job. She hates what being here, blah, blah, blah. Okay, she's going to be one of your, you know, one of those liabilities that you let go immediately or have her give you her notice, which we have a training, by the way, in this academy on how you never have to let anybody go again. I'm going to teach you how to get people to let themselves go and give you their 2 weeks, at least the ones that are liabilities to you in your store. Okay, moving on. Review the most recent loss prevention logs and prior inventory counts to really help you understand what has been going on shrink-wise. You need to know what's been going on in that store, what kind of losses you've had in the past. Again, this is going to help you develop a long-term strategy of success and to know what you're going after. All right. Now, I'm going to just do bullet points real quick here because we talked about this in the first lesson. But you need to have a quick meeting with, well, not quick. You need to have a meeting with your boss. Understand the clear expectations that he or her have for you beyond performance. Performance is important, right? But what are some other expectations of, you know, merchandising wise, staff wise, you know, financially, where does the store need to be? And then you need to ask for resources. Get help from the surrounding stores. Anything you need to ask for up front. Do not be ashamed to ask for help. Your DM's going to understand the situation of the store, and you may have all the confidence in the world that you can take care of every single one of them, but don't burden yourself with such a heavy burden that you set yourself up to fail. If you need help from surrounding stores to do a blitz, maybe it's just a 2-day blitz that'll help re-merchandise everything, ask for it. Get it done, okay? Or if you have enough staff to get it done, you just need labor, ask for the labor. And at the end of the day, make sure all of this is in writing because you never know when your boss gets promoted or goes to another company or gets fired. And then people are asking why you had all this extra labor that you were spending and your boss isn't there to account for it. Make sense? Have it in writing and also have an outline of success, okay? Have written out your plan over the next 30, 60, 90 days so you and your boss are on the same level. Next, store meeting with all of your employees, okay? During the first week, you need to schedule a store meeting with every staff associate. Make sure they're all there. It's mandatory. Again, we talked about this in the first lesson, but you need to make sure you talk about big picture goals over the next 6 to 12 months. You need to look back to move forward. Give your team positive feedback about past milestones and achievements. Reinforce and explain the customer in-store experience and how it's very important to you that we always focus on the customer. Next, you're going to meet one-on-one with your team. Schedule a one-on-one sit-down with each associate, starting with your lower-level management. During this interview, don't make it about you. Make it about them. And at the end of the meeting, briefly discuss your expectations and goals. At the conclusion of your meeting, gather your notes and build a list of A players, right? Who are your best people? Then build a list of liabilities. These are individuals that will need to be let go right away. Of course, partner with your DM and HR to make it happen, but you've got to let go of those liabilities as quick as possible. I'm going to talk about that in another lesson of how detrimental liabilities will be to your business and can cause you to lose your entire community and customer base. Then you need to build your list of trainables. These are people in the middle that are trainable, and you have your A team, your A players, train the trainables. I'm not going to talk too much more about that because we talked a lot about it in lesson one. again, just rehashing lesson one, define the team norms. Make sure through the process of getting to know everyone that you define the team norms. Make sure these are in writing and they're posted. Begin to build your high performance culture, right? Use the training that you will receive through this academy and apply the principles to build a high performance team. Work on the business 80% of the time and 20% in the business. You've got to really switch your mentality from being a worker to being a facilitator. Work on your business, not in your business. I teach business owners this same concept. They get wrapped up in their business so much, they're working in it day in and day out that they forget to work on the business. You need to do the same as a store manager, work on the business 80% of the time and 20% in the business. You need to develop a culture of self-reliance and confidence with independent decision-making. I'm talking about your team. You've got to build that self-reliance. You've got to help them be confident with independent decision-making. And we'll have a course on that in itself to help you build that high-performance team. Lastly, it's time to build and execute a 30, 60, and 90-day plan of success. Be specific on how you will execute your action plan. Your store should be running like a well-oiled machine after 90 days. If maybe this is your second store and you can relate to this, I can tell you, you probably did not have a well-oiled machine after 90 days. It probably took you 6 to 9 months. If you use these principles, you will have a well-oiled machine after 90 days and you're going to be profitable and you're going to be really turning some heads in a good way throughout your corporation. Now, first things first, during the first 30 days, here's some of the things. This doesn't include everything. These are just some highlights. First, you need to fix the big issues discovered through your audit, right? Operational excellence is a fancy word I've used in the past. Look at all the big issues, the merchandising issues, take care of them right away. Let go of the employees that are liabilities. That's first 30 days. This should be the first 5 days once you figured out who your liabilities are. You've got to get rid of them, guys. Partner with HR, partner with your DM, whoever you know is involved in this process. But get rid of your liabilities as fast as possible or you're going to be working backwards. You're going to be pushing up against a rock when everybody else is pushing three different directions. You're not going to go anywhere with the store. Next, meet with your boss, write up your 90-day plan, okay? Start the retraining process of the trainables using your A players. Hold a store meeting one-on-one and do one-on-one meetings with your staff. Embody and reinforce the new store culture. So you may have a culture that you're trying to build within the store and you might be working against a bad culture of self-destruction that's been built for the last couple of years. So, excuse me, you need to embody this new culture. You need to be talking about it every single day. You need to reinforce it. You need to be that culture, okay? Now, as you approach the 60-day mark, you need to shift your focus on improving every metric and KPI the company grades you on. It's really important that you are on the green list, right? Not in the red list on all those metrics that your store is being measured by against every other store in the company. This is where you need to start shifting your focus on improving those metrics. You're only going to improve those metrics if you are really teaching your team to embrace the new culture, the new customer service culture, sales-driven culture, whatever culture you have in your store, it's got to be metric related. You've got to be able to measure every change that you make. Then you need to continue to build your team of trainables into A players. At this point, you should be hiring and training the replacements of your recently terminated liabilities. Makes sense? You've got to get those people out and get some great people in and get them trained as quick as possible. Most action items should be finished during this 60-day period. Now, during the last 30 days of your action plan, you should be mostly focused on fine-tuning every process. You need to ensure all operations are being executed properly, store standards are being met, customer service culture being embraced and tying up any loose ends. Okay. And then lastly, you need to be sure you meet with your boss during this last month to make sure he or she is completely satisfied with the results. Now it's time to draw back on your hours and work and focus on building the business and growing your team. Congratulations on getting through lesson two. Next lesson, we are going to talk about breaking down the department walls within your organization, within the store, and really building a cohesive team that works together towards the same goals. Thank you for spending this short time with me. I look forward to working with you through the rest of this academy. And congratulations once again on making the decision to go through this academy to improve your skills as a store manager. You are going to be that success story that you've always read about, that you've always hoped to be. Going through this academy, you will be learning the principles that are going to make you a success, that made me a success, that helped me go from being a part-time hourly associate all the way up to a regional manager, from being flat broke to making high six figures in just a seven-year period, because I applied these principles that you are going to learn through this academy. So stay tuned. I look forward to working with you on each lesson. And if you're not on our weekly conference calls, be sure you get on those. If you have any specific questions, something that you're afraid to ask your boss or your peers, you can ask on these conference calls and I will address your questions directly to help you get back on track as a manager. If you're an assistant manager trying to get promoted and you have a unique circumstance that might be stopping you from getting promoted, I'm going to help you through answer that those questions, give you a plan to get after that promotion and get you back on track. If you're trying to get promoted to a DM position or a corporate position, you're not sure how to get there, I'm going to cover a lot of those things through this course that'll help you get there. But if there's specific questions, you're going to ask these on the conference call and I'm going to be answering you directly. We'll also have some strong leaders on these calls, tenured store managers and district managers and regionals. Even at times we'll have special guests, executive VPs and CEOs of some of your big companies that are out there. And they're all here to help you be successful. Okay, thanks for tuning in, and I will see you on the next lesson.